third speaker today is John M. We have two Johns actually, so it's going to be John M. And his speech is on planning and evaluating. John's speech is Nancy. Nancy, can you stand up and tell us what you're going to be looking for?
Hello everyone. So today, John M.C. is going to be providing his speech number two. It's going to be about organizing your speech. What I'm going to be looking for is this a speech easy to follow? You know, is it a, is his message clear? Is his transitions, you know, going to the one point to the next very smoothly? And essentially, he's going to be able to open a strong opening and conclusion, and looking forward to your speech.
And your topic is planning. That's right. Planning, take it away.
So Yogi Berra led the Yankees to 14 World Series, and in one year there were streakers protesting something. Everybody know what streakers are? And somebody asked him, "So, are they women or men?" He looked and said, "I don't know. They were wearing bags over their heads." That's Yogi. He's awesome. Okay, so I'm Mr. Toastmaster, members and guests. Today I'm going to talk about planning. So I don't know if everybody was here last week, but Kevin gave us a framework for evaluating our audience called the STAR framework. I happen to be a type A person, so I'm one of the types that likes to jump in and hates planning. And so planning is something I've had to learn over time. And I don't think that's uncommon. When I've talked to, sort of done informal polls, I found that people are sort of split, half love to plan, half hate to plan. And I wanted to say in this talk that no matter what your orientation towards planning is, if you're letting that orientation determine how you run your business, you're probably inducing some risk and leaving some opportunities on the table. So that's what I wanted to talk about planning. So I organized the speech into the obvious things about planning, the not so obvious things about planning, then John's super secret pro planning tip. So I have it set up. So first, the obvious stuff. So I don't care if you're trying to do anything in life. If you have a committed purpose that you want to accomplish, you need some sort of plan to get there. And purpose is so important that I'm not going to talk about that in any detail because I might save that for another idea. So I don't care if you're going to the grocery store, go to the hardware store, doing a vacation, or maybe something that's a little bit more important to yourself, like career planning or even estate planning. You need a plan of how you're going to reach that purpose and how you're going to accomplish things. And if you notice the things that I talked about, going to the grocery store, it's not a big deal. If you forget the flour or something like that, you just go back again. But if you mess up something like your estate planning, well, then the implications are large. So the amount of planning you put into anything is directly related to how important it is for your life and how complicated. And maybe with something like estate planning, you can get expert help. So that's kind of the obvious planning stuff. Now, what about the not so obvious things? Well, there's a Prussian general from the 1800s called Helmut von Moltke the Elder, not to be confused with the Younger, who said, this quote that's become famous, but the original quote is terrible. It said, "No plan of operations extends with any certainty beyond first contact with the opposing force." Terrible quote. But there's a little nugget of gold in that, and so General Helmut had a lot of editorial help over the years, and that's been shortened to, "No plan survives first contact with the enemy." So you can kind of get your head around that. That's easier, and it means the same thing. So I can hear all of you type A's out there, and that's probably most of us because we're here jumping in, doing things, going, "Hooray! I don't need to plan because plans never survive contact with the enemy." Well, that's not true. Because here's the not so obvious truth about planning, which is plans aren't, the value of a plan isn't having your plan go A, B, C, D, you know, perfectly. The value of planning is thinking about it and working with it and thinking about all the things that can go wrong. So you go on vacation and Pat's not here, but your elephant stumbles. You go to run your marathon in Hawaii and it's hotter than you expected. You're running out of gas sooner than you thought. Like, this is reality smacking into your plan. So this is why plans are valuable. Now you know you're off track. So another example is if you're doing saving for college for your children. You probably have a plan that says by a certain date I'll have a certain amount of money saved and then I'll be able to go to, you know, through a certain school. Now, if you're going through your plan and you realize that's not the case, well, you've got a control point. Now, maybe the stock market didn't return what you were expecting, or if some series of things happened, you've got to change your plan. So that's the value of plan. The value of plan is not when things go right, it's when things go wrong, and knowing early enough to do something about it. So that's my value for plans. So the the John super secret pro planning tip. So again, I had to, like, planning's a discipline that didn't come natural to me, and I've run some large teams with big complicated business-to-business relationships. Very complicated, we're trying to hit very important goals at the end, and I started doing these planning sessions where we put a lot of energy into it and have a big review at the end of the year, and then we never touch it again. I think that's really common. Planning's tough. So what I found is you need something that's flexible enough. In a marketplace that changes as fast as this one, I mean, I don't know, I'm led to believe that 20, 30 years ago, it was really common to work 6 months or 9 months on a business plan. So you'd work on this thing, you'd create every aspect of your business you could possibly capture into a plan, and then you take that into a bank for funding. And the next time that would get put on some shelf and get dusty, and the next time it would be looked at is the next time that you need money. But the marketplace is not that way anymore. So now we have companies like Uber that are worth $50 billion after just a couple of years. So we have a marketplace that's changing monthly, weekly, daily. So if your planning process takes months, 6 months at a time, it's already invalid before you've even gotten through the first half of the plan. So now you need something that's flexible and so useful that you're looking at it all the time. Maybe you're looking at it weekly and talking about that with your team. And so that's my super secret pro tip. I have now developed plans, and I'm very interested in talking to those of you that do planning as a part of your natural business and personal life, what's working for you. But now I do quick plans, try to hit the salient points of what I'm trying to hit, and review it very frequently, and I found that's very helpful. So I hope that's brought you, if you're a plan hater or a planning lover, I hope that's brought you all the way around to the end to see that, you know, if you are planning too much, that's bad. If you're planning too little, also bad. So try to find that tuning in the right level of planning that you can produce documents. Very, very useful. So thank you so much. That's my talk on planning. Thank you.